people change, you know. That's all I can say. I changed, he changed, we all changed.
Change has been a constant during Journey's three decades of existence. The only permanent player has been co-founder Neil Schon, a Bay Area native who was captivated by music before he was even in his teens.
I used to have this little turntable in my bedroom, and I had like three or four records that I'd play every night. Cream, Hendrix, Hendrix, Cream. I'd go to sleep listening to this stuff all night long.
By the spring of 68, Neil was a 14-year-old budding guitar maestro, a familiar face at Bay Area studios. He soon began jamming with Greg Raleigh, singer and keyboardist for the Latin fusion supergroup Santana.
Got a black magic woman. Got a black magic woman.
I used to go pick him up from high school, because he really wasn't going to high school. He was there, but he wasn't going to high school.
He'd come up. I'd split with him and we'd go play music.
Impressed by his young friend's wicked guitar licks, Greg helped Neil make a demo tape, then passed it along to Santana road manager, Herbie Herbert.
I heard this demo tape, it would floor me today. He was only 15 years old, it would still wreck me that a kid could play that at that level of expression. And so, man, you gotta get that kid to come and hang around. I gotta meet this kid.
Herbie was quickly taken with the young guitarist. And so was Carlos Santana, who asked Neil to join his group in the summer of 69. So at just 15 years old, Neil left high school and embarked on a life of rock and roll.
I just thought it was part of the norm at that time. I don't know. I look back at it now and I realize that it was a pretty amazing time period in my life. And it just freaks me out every time I see an old Santana video or look at myself and I'm like, I'm a baby, basically.
By May of 72, Schon and Raleigh had tired of the Santana sound, and so had road manager Herbie Herbert. Herbie decided to build a new band, putting the spotlight on Greg's creative keyboard playing and Neil's stunning axe work.
Neil was, I thought, the quintessential guitar expressionist of the